Hello everyone. In this video, we will be adding and subtracting rational expressions, and this is the second part. In this part, we're going to have rational expressions that do not have the same denominator. So as you can see here, the denominator of the first rational expression is not the same as the denominator of the second rational expression. There are steps that we need to follow in order that we can solve this kind of problem. The first step is to make sure that the denominators are the same. Since their denominators are not the same, we have to make sure that they have to be the same. So I'm just going to go ahead and write this all out, and I'll give you a trick on how to make their denominators the same. Okay, since in the first step we're supposed to make their denominators the same, what are we going to do is that we're going to look at the denominator of the first one. So it has x minus 1 and x minus 1 on the second. So that means the second one is missing this x plus 3. So what are we going to do is we are going to multiply a giant 1 to the second expression. So I'm going to multiply this by x plus 3 over x plus 3 to make their denominators even. So this x plus 3 over x plus 3 is actually 1. So if you divide these two, that's actually equal to 1. So then we can go ahead and rewrite this as... Okay, as you can see here, they already have the same denominator. But what are we going to do with the 4 here is that we distribute this 4 to each of the terms inside the parentheses. So then we can go ahead and simplify this further. Okay, so what I did was I distributed the 4 to the x and 4 to the 3. That's how we got 4x plus 12. Okay, so as you can see here, we already have the same denominator. So then we can go ahead and move on to the next step. The second step is to add or subtract the numerator and keep the common denominator and simplify when needed. Since these denominators here are already the same, we can go ahead and write their common denominator. So we can go ahead and write this x minus 1 and x plus 3, since that is common to both of them. And we are going to add these two here. So I'm going to put the x plus 2 inside the parentheses, plus, and then I'm going to write this one out again inside the parentheses, 4x plus 12. So then from here, we can go ahead and distribute the positive to each of the terms inside the parentheses. So once we distribute that, we can go ahead and rewrite this as... Okay, so what I did was I wrote this x plus 2, and then since I distributed the plus here to each of the terms inside the parentheses, I got plus 4x plus 12. So then we are going to combine like terms. So as you can see here, we have x plus 4x is 5x. So I can go ahead and write 5x over here. And then I'm going to combine the constants here, so that would be 2 plus 12 is 14, so that is a plus 14 over x minus 1, x plus 3. So this is the sum of these two rational expression up here. So I'm just going to go ahead and write this as the sum up here. At this time, I would encourage you to pause this video and try this problem out on your own. And when you're done, unpause it and check your answer. Okay, so we go over the problem here. Again, we pretty much have the same step. The first step is to make sure that the denominators are the same. So in this problem right here, their denominators are not the same. So I'm just going to go ahead and rewrite this so that we can make their denominators the same. Okay, to make their denominator the same, again, the trick is we figure out which ones are common and which ones missing in the other rational expression. So the ones that's missing on the second rational expression is x plus 5. So then I can go ahead and multiply this by x plus 5 on both numerators and the denominator. So that would be x plus 5 and x plus 5 to make their denominators even. So then we can go ahead and rewrite this as okay, so what are we gonna do next is that this part right here can be expanded using the area model. So we can go ahead and multiply these two. So we're gonna use the area model for this. I'm gonna show the work for the area model on the side here. Okay, so we can go ahead and simplify this part right here with this so that we can go ahead and rewrite this as okay, so what are we gonna do next is that we are going to take all their common denominators and we are going to simplify it. So their denominator is already the same, so then we can go ahead and simplify it. So in this side right here, I'm just gonna write their common denominator, which is x minus 2, x plus 5. And then what I would do next is I will write this part right here. So the first numerator or the first expression is x plus 3, and that's a minus. And then I'm going to put this second numerator inside the parentheses. That's x squared plus 6x plus 5. And then what I would do next is I will distribute this negative right here to each of the terms inside the parentheses. So then this would come out okay, now what are we gonna do next is we combine like terms. So the like terms here would be the x squared doesn't have any other term that has x squared on it. So we can keep that as negative x squared. And then but we have the x here and then minus 6x. So x minus 6x is negative 5x. And then the constant that we have here is positive 3 minus 5. So 3 minus 5 is negative 2, and then that is over x minus 2, and then x plus 5. So this is the difference between these two rational expressions that we have up here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and write this to be equal to did you get the same answer as this? Yeah! Good. Perfect. If you find this video helpful, hit like and subscribe for more math videos. See ya.